Hello guys, in this video, I will show you how to make the DIY oscilloscope using Arduino Nano. Without wasting the time, let's get started. Before getting started, click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new video. These high quality PCBs are ordered from JLC PCB for just $2. To order PCBs, go to jlcpcb.com. And log in with your account. After logging into the account, click on Quote Now. Then add your jabber files. You can get the PCBs delivered for only $2. After successfully uploading your jabber files, you can change the properties below here and then can't save to the cart. Then check out securely to get delivered your PCBs soon. The components required are the PCB, the female header pins, and Arduino Nano, the terminal block, and OLED display, and few jumper wires. This is the PCB I designed for this OLED oscilloscope. You can download from the link in the description. At the first, we will solder the female header pins here, here and here, and a terminal block here, and we will insert these components on the board. Taking the measurement of the Arduino Nano, and now I will break the strip. And we need to break this into the part of 4. Now we place the header pins on the board and we will solder it. Now I will solder the header pins. Now we will place the terminal block here and we will solder it. Now we will place the Arduino Nano and OLED display on the board. First, we'll start with the Arduino Nano. Insert it carefully. Now here the OLED display. It is the I2C OLED display module. Okay. This is the header pins. It is used to take the input and to display on the oscilloscope. The A0 pin is the input. A3 pin is the ground. Now we will upload the code to this Arduino Nano board. Before uploading the code, you need to install the Adafruit SST1306 library and Adafruit GFX library. You can download from the link in the description, and after including it in the code, now connect your Arduino Nano board. And select the port. And click on upload button. The code is uploaded. Now you can see on the display. Now I will connect the A0 pin to the D11. You can see the PWM output. I already set the PWM output for the D11 pin in the code. That's all in this video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I will see you in the next one.